The way this works is, let's say you have a business that is selling skis, okay, and you have on your profile that you are interested in skiing, but let's say you haven't made that public, but you share it with your friends, right? So broadly, we don't tell the advertiser that here's a list of people who like skis. They just say, okay, we're trying to sell skis. Can you reach people who like skis? And then we match that up on our side without sharing any of that information.
Understood. You don't share that, but they get access to that information so that if they know that they want to market skis to me because I like skis. On the realm of data that is accessible to them, does Facebook include deleted data?
Congressman, no.
Okay.
And I also would push back on the idea that we're giving them access to the data. We allow them to reach people who said that on Facebook, but we're not giving them access to the data.
Fair. So can advertisers either directly or indirectly get access to or use the metadata that Facebook collects in order to more specifically target ads? So that would include, I know you've talked a lot about how Facebook would use access to information for folks that, well, I might be able to opt in or out about your ability to track me to other websites. Is that used by those advertisers as well?
Congressman, I'm not sure I understand the question. Can you give me an example of what you mean?
Does the advertisers that are using your platform, do they get access to information that the user does not actually think is either one being generated or two is public? Understanding that, yes, if you dive into the details of your platform, users might be able to shut that off. But I think one of the challenges with trust here is that there's an awful lot of information that's generated that people don't think that they're generating and that advertisers are being able to target because Facebook collects it.
Yes. So, Congressman, my understanding is that the targeting options that are available for advertisers are generally things that are based on what people share. Now, once an advertiser chooses how they want to target something, Facebook also does its own work to help rank and determine which ads are going to be interesting to which people. So we may use metadata or other behaviors of what you've shown that you're interested in newsfeed or other places in order to make our systems more relevant to you. But that's a little bit different from giving that as an option to an advertiser, if that makes sense.
Right. But then I guess the question back to, and I only got 20 seconds, I think one of the rubs that you're hearing is, I don't understand how users then own that data. I think that's part of the rub. Second, you focus a lot of your testimony and the questions on the individual privacy aspects of this, but we haven't talked about the societal implication of it. And I think while I applaud some of the reforms that you're putting forward, the underlying issue here is that your platform has become a mix of news, entertainment, social media that is up for manipulation. We've seen that with a foreign actor. If the changes to individual privacy don't seem to be sufficient to address that underlying issue.
Time has expired.
Love your comments on that at the appropriate time. Thank you.
Chair, I recognize a gentleman from Texas, Mr. Flores, for 4 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.